Hi everybody, welcome to another episode of Fish Keeping Jamaica. Welcome to Aquariology, in which I'll be sharing with you some facts about fish. This is part 3, take 2. Now today we'll be looking at swim bladder disease, or commonly called the flip over or the fish swim disorder. Okay, stay.
Some cry, some smile, some fight every day. We rise to the top, 'cause we know what it takes. Through it all we survive, yet still hold the faith. Unchangeable, Lord, unchangeable.
Hey. If you have been in the fish keeping habit, no matter how great you are with your fish, at times things happen. One of such things that may occur within your experience in fish keeping habit is swim bladder issues with your fish. Today my video will be focused on swim bladder disease. What is it? What causes it? This is a series in parts in aquariology, so I'll be looking at various aspects of fish keeping, and I also will be looking at the different role each section of the fish anatomy plays within its daily life. So let us look at the swim bladder, right? The swim bladder is a disease referred to as swim disease, right? Flip over. It is common in the fish keeping habit. It's common for persons who actually keep fish in an aquarium usually have this experience. This occurs when the bladder is not functioning properly. You see, the swim bladder is an internal organ filled with, some persons would say it's filled with gas, but for some fish it's not filled with gas, it is filled with air, right? Now what happens is that the gas or the air contributes to the ability of the fish to actually control its buoyancy, its movement in the water. You know, fish goes left, right, up, down, right, forward, backward, right? The swim bladder actually controls this within the fish, and thus it stays within the water, and it prevents the swim bladder prevent the fish from actually drowning. Yes, a fish can drown. I will be looking at that also in aquariology, right? So the fish is not wasting its energy trying to fight the current of the water so as to swim. It just comes naturally because this buoyancy exists. The swim bladder is located behind the rest of the organ in the fish, usually to the back end of the fish, right? Your fish might float, that's if you have swim, if your fish have swim bladder disorder, right? Your fish might float to the top of the tank or sink to the bottom. They may swim sideways or float upside down, right? The spine may look curved and the belly will look full or bloated, right? Most commonly, swim bladder can occur when your fish is 1, overfed; 2, it can also occur as a result of the fish gulping in too much air; 3, it can also occur as a result of the fish experiencing a rapid change in water temperature. Right, when the metabolism, this makes the metabolism of the fish, the ability of the fish to break down food or to convert food into energy much slower. So therefore, there's a little gap there, and the fish kind of, it's like when you're, you know, like sometimes you'll be talking and like a gulp of air reach your throat, right? That affects the fish, right? Okay, main cause of swim bladder is overfeeding, right, which leads to constipation, right? Another cause is gulping of air, as I said before, when the fish comes up and grab the food, right? So therefore, whenever you take too long to feed your fish, you know, like, I don't know if you have ever experienced this, but like, I'm very hungry and I go around the table, food is there, and I will be like eating the food, and it's really food, you know, I'm hungry and I really want the food to go to my tummy. It's like I feel a sense of like something here holding me. I can't even swallow it properly. I have to hold on and share, right? Fish also go through that, right? And this can lead to swim bladder disorder, right? Enlarged organs and infection can cause swim bladder disorder, because you all know that our fish within the aquarium are faced with a lot of infectious parasite disease and issues that affect them internally, right? So as a result of this, the swim bladder just doesn't work or doesn't function properly. Now, as it relates to water temperature can prove problematic if your fish swim bladder. Water temperature can affect your fish swim bladder. You see, what happens is that cooler water temperature lowers the metabolism, which makes it harder for the food to pass through their system, right? So it's kind of difficult for them to actually break down the food, so the swim bladder is under pressure. Make sure to keep the water clean at all times and keep the temperature at its regulated, or should I say, at its recommended gauge. You know, every fish have its recommended gauge, right? For example, carps can live in extreme cold condition, right? While some other fish, some tropical Central American and South American cichlids, they can't, but as soon as the time start get cold, they will eventually die, right? So really, to continue it with swim bladder, make sure that the water is clean at all times and keep the temperature as to the recommended amount Fahrenheit, right? You can soak the food before feeding the fish so that the fish don't choke on it, so as to actually have a little gap there, which will, you know, affect the swim bladder, right? You can soak dry food before feeding or thaw frozen food, right? Another thing, also make sure to only feed the appropriate amount, right? I know sometimes a fish might look as if it's want more, but just like a baby, my son easy. My son will see the food and he wants it, but his stomach is full. After he's finished eating, he can't get up because it's either that or I'm a bad tube or I'm a pain in his tummy, right? Because the food is so nice, he's continuously eating. Same too with fish, right? So some of the habits in which we have, fish also have too. In wrapping up, you need to remember that the fish stomach is as big as its eye. I repeat, the fish stomach is as big as its eye. So therefore, if you feed the fish too much, right, it will affect the feed fish health. This is Riley here for Fish Keeping Jamaica, as it relates to swim bladder and aquariology, right? As it relates to swim bladder in aquariology, I have just shared with you some common ways in which fish actually become affected with swim bladder disease. Join me next time when I speak to you more in depth about how you can manage this. Bye-bye.